Don't Look Up is a film directed by Adam McKay, starring everyone. Leonardo DiCaprio, Jennifer Lawrence, Rob Morgan, Meryl Streep, Jonah Hill, Cate Blanchett, Ariana Grande, Kid Cudi. I'm sure I'm leaving people out. The premise is that when a grad student, played by Jennifer Lawrence, who in this movie attends Michigan State University, about 20 minutes from where I was born and raised, she discovers that there's a comet headed towards Earth with a near 100% chance of causing human extinction. Now, her and her professor, played by Leonardo DiCaprio, try to warn and potentially save the public from nearly certain doom. I'm going to take off the sunglasses because we're inside. Don't Look Up is a very divisive movie. Adam McKay's two previous films, The Big Short and Vice, were critically acclaimed. They both got nominated for multiple Academy Awards. This movie currently, I believe, sits at a 56% on Rotten Tomatoes, which by their metric is considered a rotten rating. I think it's one of the best comedies I've seen in a long time. I think this movie is absolutely brilliant. I am floored and in awe at how much I enjoyed this movie. It's one of my favorite films of the year. Adam McKay has always been a really brilliant director with actors. Even just going back to his, you know, the sillier, like, Will Ferrell movies that he's did. He's always great at getting the most out of his actors. Here is no exception. Jennifer Lawrence, I think, is just better suited for comedy. I really, like, and I'm not saying she's a bad dramatic actress, but this is, like, one of my favorite performances of hers. Brilliant performance by DiCaprio in this. I think he's gotten better as he's gotten older. This is one of my favorite performances of his because it's so drastically different from many of the other projects that he's taken on in the past. This is a comedy, and this movie is funny as shit. There are some great jokes, there's some great one-liners, some great physical comedy, but even beyond that, the satire itself is borderline flawless. This movie is bitter, which some people aren't going to appreciate, but it never felt mean-spirited to me. Adam McKay's previous film, Vice, really to me felt more pretentious with its message. I think that Adam McKay is just a director. He's similar to Bobcat Goldthwait in that aspect, where he's just a director who's fed up with the state of politics, the state of pop culture, and he made a movie that, in my opinion, borderline flawlessly skewered both. I have to talk about a director's intent when praising a movie, that, like, you can't grade every movie the same. You have to grade every movie based on what the director was going for, and it's one of the reasons why this is one of the best movies of the year. Adam McKay hit his target here completely for me. The jokes worked, the satire worked, the story worked. I thought it was sensational. It's so bizarre to me because I've heard people say that this movie should have been more fun, and my response to that is no. Like, you're feeding into what the movie is going for, like, one of the messages of the movie, which is that we sensationalize things that are, like, horribly horrific. Like, we're talking about the apocalypse. The entire world's coming to an end. There's nothing fun about that. And secondly, the movie to me was fun. This movie's really entertaining. I laughed the entire way through. Like, I don't know what people are looking for saying it should have been more fun. This is a great movie, but it's not the most flawless thing I've ever seen. I do have some problems with it. The movie is over 2 hours, and that's ridiculous for a comedy. Now, it held my interest longer than I expected it to. So this is almost like this. It is a detriment to the movie, but it's almost a compliment where, like, I was amazed that it kept me as invested as it did for as long as it did. I think that 95% of the humor here works. I think 95% of the satire works, but there is that 5% that's just a little bit too on the nose with its message and what it was skewering. And you're like, okay, like, for instance, there's a part near the end of the movie in which there's a group of people who are wearing red hats with, like, a message on it. And it's like, okay, we get it. And so you're going, yeah, okay, you're poking fun at the Trump era. Like, it wasn't that it was horribly unfunny. It's just, it's one of the few moments in the movie where I felt like the satire was too obvious. Maybe this isn't a fair criticism, but there's two credit sequences in this movie. And I thought they stunk. I wish they would have done without them. I know one of them is technically paying off something that happened earlier in the movie, but I thought it was kind of lame and unnecessary. I think that if you are somebody who is an eternal optimist, if you believe that the world is great, and people are great, and that our country is great, you're probably going to watch this movie and feel uncomfortable. And you know what? There's really no problem with that. Personal taste is a thing. Like, it's something that just exists. And if you don't get a lot of enjoyment or a lot of laughs out of this movie, that's totally fine. Now, if you're somebody like me, who is eternally pessimistic, who has a glass half empty view of the world, I think you're going to find this really funny. Like, we live in the dumbest timeline possible. Like, one of the reasons why I think people are divided about this movie is the fact that, like, this is not so much a satire at points as much as it's a cautionary tale. If a real comet was about to hit Earth, people would react the exact same way that they reacted in this movie. Because that's just the timeline we're in. We are in a world that is being held together by duct tape and bubblegum. And when I watch this, I'm like, wow, this movie so captures into the bitterness that I think a lot of people feel nowadays. And by the way, I am a part of that stupid timeline. I am not above anybody by any means. But when I watch this, like, I do relate to Adam McKay's cynicism here. And a lot of people won't, and that's fine. I did, and I think it's one of the best comedies I've ever seen. I give this, man, I can't believe I'm saying this. I'm giving this a 9.5 out of 10. This is my second favorite movie of the year. It's almost number one. Like, I don't think it has a lot of serious flaws. And I'm surprised by this because I'm not a huge fan of him as a director. I really enjoyed Vice. I acknowledge The Big Short was a really good movie, but I couldn't get into it. You know, I like some of his sillier comedies. But this, I don't know, man. This was a bullseye for me. I think that this is one of the better movies of the year. I'm floored by it. I recommend it. With the caveat knowing that a lot of people are not going to connect with it the way that I did. So that'll do it for this review. You can follow me on Twitter at Castellani2014. While you're at it, hit that like button. Hit that subscribe button. Let's get those watch hours up, up, up. Let me know what you thought, but keep it civil. It's the holidays, and it's a movie. Like, calm down. All right. Thank you very much for watching, everybody. Have a great rest of your day. Peace and happiness.